You guys got your boarding passes with you?
Yeah, I forgot my passport, though. Do you think it's gonna be okay?
You should go back to the old country.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The old country, that's where my grandparents retired to, because it's filled with old people.
Oh my god. Wow, this is a really small plane. I guess he said he acquired it. It's probably a private jet.
I do like the idea of a private jet that still, like, sort of looks economy class a little bit. It's private, but you don't want to have it too good.
Yeah. The seats aren't comfy, but, like, you don't have to, like, crawl over anyone to go to the bathroom.
Okay, listen. I have figured out the formula for what makes rich people so crazy, and it turns out the bigger your plane is, the more your brain just turns upside down.
Well, right, because it's an inverse proportion, right? You know, people are, like, buy the hot rods and they're like, oh, they're compensating for something. It's the same with private jets.
Right, that explains why FutureFriend has a plane the size of the entire sky.
Hey.
Also, man, they skipped a lot.
No. My brain is in the right position 24/7, Jay.
Your plane's so big, your damn brain flipped back right side up.
Also, I like that the...
That's good, right?
Yeah. Also, I like that the concern is not, oh, Giorno, your hands are gonna fall off. It's, if your hands fall off, you can't help us! Real utilitarian sort of mafia team here.
I mean, that's how the mafia works, Chirps.
I guess so.
They're not here to just, like, be good friends with each other. They're here because they want something.
Right, everyone's an asset.
I like the implication that this isn't a stand in the game universe. It's just like, this is like a Twilight Zone episode now.
Yeah, William Shatner's gonna be on the wing of the plane.
And he's like, oh, there's a man inside the plane!
Hey, you know, Giorno just lost both his hands, but Tris, just, you know, take a nap.
Just chill out.
You'll be fine.
There are some snacks here that you can have. You can have some small bags of peanuts.
Maybe pretzels if you're lucky.
Ooh, yeah.
You're like, Trish, wouldn't it be so much fun to play flight attendant? You can go in the back and get all the sodas and not give us a full can of any of them.
Trish just turns the camera and goes, remember when planes used to give out honey roasted peanuts? Those were the days.
Oh, wow, they did? They yeah. Sure were the days.
I like that all of Giorno's brooches are attached with, like, safety pins. Do you think he made them himself?
Yes. He just looks like a little brain just rolling around.
He looks like a Digimon.
Oh yeah, one of the baby ones? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was gonna say he looks like an off-brand Pokemon, but then I remembered there was a name for those.
Damn!
In this battle, you shouldn't move too much. Now, this sounds like a big pain in the ass. But fortunately, moving with the D-pad always means you're moving slowly.
Okay.
So, this actually isn't as tedious as you think it is. It's still kind of tedious, though.
Okay, yeah, I can see it. Oh my god, it throws you all the way back.
Yes.
This is some fucking, like, red light, green light shit, Jesus.
Yeah, I was about to say, this is the worst Mario Party minigame I've ever played.
The big problem with it is that, like, if you miss, like, attacking one of the chairs, you are just going back.
That sucks.
So, you gotta be very, like, precise with your shit, and, well, sometimes it feels like you're just in a position to hit a chair, and you don't, and then you get owned, and that's life.
Is it possible to, like, hit all the chairs and then just be unable to continue? Like, you have to die?
Probably.
Okay.
I've never had it happen, though. I assume that takes, like, 30 minutes of being in here.
Sure.
Like, that could technically happen, but the heat death of the universe would happen first.
Right.
Let's not go that far. I'd say you'd probably be done with a full watch-throughs of The Sopranos before you can get all of those chairs out.
Okay. Which Sopranos is the American adaptation of JoJo's Part 5.
That's right.
Spice Girl is very bad about personal space and, you know, like, the bubble, in a way.
Oh, this fight got cool now.
I can't believe it. We finally found a JoJo character that doesn't respect personal space. It took us this long.
Wow, this still seems like it sucks ass, though.
No, this is good. This is what good gameplay is like, Terps.
This looks like content to me. Damn. Damn. Spice Girl seems cool, though.
Yeah, I mean, she seems like she's very context-dependent on this stage, though.
Yeah, it sucks that, like, Trish never gets another fight. Because the power, I think, is very interesting, and, like, I think, like, watching the animation of this, like, rubber seat is very funny.
Yeah.
So I just want it, like, on other things.
Oh, God. I love when, like, PS2 games just show off, like, hey, look at the fucked up things we can do with 3D models.
Right, almost like it's like a tech demo, but they're like, oh wait, we could do something with this. Oh, nice! I really like that you can hit it while it's jumping at you.
Oh yeah, it's very precise timing, but I always have a smile on my face when I manage to get it.
Move over, Dark Souls, this is the real parrying. Yeah, the only issue I see with this stage is that it just seems like it's very long.
It's very long, but that's alright, you know? This is a game that's like 4 hours.
Sure.
That's true. So,
sometimes you gotta have one that challenges more than just, like, how fast you can hit the attack button.
Like, when exactly do I get to do that stupid fucking, like, kick there?
Exactly. Just stomp on him a little bit.
It seems you've mastered Trish.
Well, good, because it's the only chance.
やった、ダメージがあった。この毒までの追跡をやめないスタンドが小さくなって消えてく。ブチャラティ、不安は解決したわ。ジョルノはすでに自分のブローチを左手に変え。それ以上動くんじゃない。
Oh, look, we already took care of that guy.
He's like, don't move, but also move.
Man, that guy looks different than before. Did he lose weight?
Yeah. He actually looks like he's absorbed Pulpo here.
This is just like the Monster Blood 2 episode of Goosebumps.
What did they do in that?
There was Monster Blood on a plane.
Right, but what did they do about it?
Did they clean it up?
I don't know, they probably ate it or something.
Did they call, like, the hospital because the monster is in trouble?
So what you're saying is they could eat it here. Oh my god!
Oh gosh.
Or crushed.
I've got some good news for you guys. I'm getting the speedrun record on this level. It's only taken me 2 minutes.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, this part is kind of really just nothing. Like, either you get this very easily and just keep him back all the way, or you just lose a lot of time and, like, he just gets closer and closer and there's not really much you can do about it.
Oh, I thought for a minute what you were doing is you were trying to push him out the back of the plane within the 2 minutes.
No. You just have to survive for 2 minutes by pushing him back so he doesn't crush you with his mass.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Seems like you've got, like, a lot of space to work with. Also, he can damage you. I thought...
No, he was taking stand damage before.
Yeah, so he's basically got two attacks. He can just punch forward, which has a lot of, like, very well-noticed anticipation frames.
Mm-hmm.
And he can just kind of, like, slap around him. So what you just kind of do is, like, do a rush combo on him like this, and then roll backwards so you're out of reach of, like, his short-range attack.
Mm-hmm. Can the stuff falling from the ceiling also hurt you?
Yes.
Okay.
However, this, I think it just only seems to spawn in the back. When I played this game first, I kept getting hit by those, but, like, nowadays, I never seem to anymore.
Yeah, it seemed like you were able to dodge roll through them all.
Why did they pack so much luggage, though?
you never know what you're gonna need when you're running away from a mafia boss.
You know how it is with private planes. Like, as soon as you don't have that carry limit anymore, you are just gonna go fucking nuts with carrying everything.
Yeah. Damn, that actually looked kind of rough by the end.
Yeah, I lost my gaming mojo, unfortunately, in an accident last week.
Ah. Well, I hope you can get it back soon.
Nah, it's gone forever. Ah, well.
Oh, okay.
No, future friend, you have to put that as, like, a Patreon, like, like stretch goal.
I get my mojo back. I also know how to drive a plane.
That's what you need the private plane for. You're flying to Sardinia to get your gamer surgery.
Oh yeah, also Baccio was here.
Right.
Almost forgot.
Baccio, if your stand's flying the plane, then who's beating up the notorious B.I.G.?
No, I gotta say, I see this a lot. They don't seem to know where to place the fucking speech bubbles in this game.
Uh-huh. Yeah, it's kind of just wherever it can fit.
Oh, well, everybody knows how the story goes at this point.
And if they didn't, they would be very confused considering about 80% of the story is gone.
Oh, well, that's it. He just flew out the back of the plane and died. The end.
I mean, what more do you want?
Also, I'd like to note, where's Giorno?
He's in the turtle or something.
He had his hands cut off, so he basically stopped existing.
Okay. Well, they found one of his hands, though.
Yeah, but they didn't find the rest of him, dummy.
Yeah, that hand is actually now the new main character.
Oh! And it's a doctor! With Giorno's hands out of the picture, we need one of those.
よし。俺と並んちゃで崖の上を調べに行く。アマキオ、お前はすぐにムーディーブルースでリプレイに取り掛かる。必要な時間はどのくらいだ？15年前までさかのぼるかな。8分から10分はかかるだろう。
This is the real reason, like, VHS went out of style. It just takes so long.
Well, I was gonna say this is the real reason Abaccio died. Like, he was rewinding for
too long.
Hey,
like, what? He does what? Oh.
He, delights.
Dyes his hair.
Yeah.
Do you think Moody Blues ever gets, like, a tape jam?
Yeah, like, it was too much pressure on, like, the tape inside, and it just, like, snaps.
He moves to Laserdisc.
The only one I see dead hair chirps is the frontman for a emo post-punk band.
Do you think you can, like, revive Moody Blues by, like, putting, like, scotch tape on it here and there to make it run again?
Oh, probably. Just, like, in the little sensors to make sure that the laser reader's working.
Mm-hmm. Someone probably at some point made a VCR sort of, kind of, shaped like Moody Blues.
Right. Just like its head.
No, I think they modeled the entire body for this gimmick VHS player.
I think that'd be great. Oh my god.
Oh my god, he kicked a hole through my body with that soccer ball.
Sports are dangerous, as it turns out.
Actually, Jay, in Italy, they call it Italian football.
Well, I don't speak fucking Italian.
Wow, we didn't even get introduced to Risotto, did we, in this one?
No, he's just dead.
He's just like, and then this guy, who you don't know, died. Wow.
We got introduced to a fucking body, and now there are two bodies.
Great!
Oh my god. The new enemy is a soccer hoodlum.
You know, I don't think there are enough sports-based stands, so I think that would be good.
Ah, that would be good.
Soccer hooligans truly are the greatest villains.
They're gonna shit their pants when they find out this soccer hooligan is British. Those guys are hardcore. Let me tell ya, those guys are hardcore.
And their stand name? That's right, it's American Baseball.
Okay, I would like for the stand to be like that one picture of the baseball with the face yelling, "Let's go!"
That frame of Narancia is... I'm not really sure how to describe it. Unfortunate is maybe a word.
Yeah, it looks like a sad horse.
I think it's Renaissance-esque.
It's Renaissance-esque in that it seems like they don't know what a person looks like.
Yeah. We gotta keep an eye out for one of these panels where they put in a weird-looking snail. Yeah, close enough.
Damn, that's a loud fucking bug.
It's a like, we don't see the ladybug, but it's huge.
It's that big.
Yeah. Oh, he just like, it's like whenever you put your hands in the wet cement so that your handprints stay.
Right, you just put your whole face in. Anyways, enough of that. He went to heaven. Who cares?
Yeah, that's Abaccio, everyone. Say goodbye.
He's dying his hair in heaven now.
Oh no, that's natural.
Oh my god, they got hacked!
Also, he's in hell. I can't believe Anonymous is trying to take down this mafia.
I mean, his name is Diafolo. That guy is bad news for everyone.
Yeah.
And he hasn't paid his income tax in 35 years.
I mean, it's very easy to not pay your taxes when well, you basically don't exist to the outside world.
Yeah, when you're a devil man, you don't have to pay your taxes.
Yeah, you gonna tax devil man? No.
When you're a devil man, you don't have to pay your taxes would make a good country western song.
Is the Bukiarati family straight up just the IRS?
Yeah. That's what's going on here.
Oh no.
I think it's kind of weird that this is an entire, like, chapter with no gameplay. Like, you should have had, like, a visual novel segment where, like, you try to woo the hacker.
I honestly think, like, the Doppio versus Rosato fight was gonna be playable at some point.
Yeah, I was surprised that wasn't part of it. They were just, like, immediately, looks like someone's dead. Right? Like...
Yeah, it feels very weird to have made, like, a Rosato model for one panel. Yeah. I think they probably just ran out of time or budget to make it.
Yeah. Like, it seems like a fight you could pretty easily do, like, oh, he throws, like, the knives at you, or he has a grab where he turns your throat into razor blades.
Right, or even it could even be, like, a quick time event fight just to do the stuff. It's a shame we lose that, because it's kind of sick.
Yeah, like, it's really one of those things where, like, they probably just focused more on, okay, each one of the main cast has to have a fight instead of just, you know, the fights that would actually be fun, because I figure the fight with Risotto would at least be more fun than the fight with Notorious B.I.G.
Yeah. Also, it sucks that he just has a phone with a cut cable.
Yeah, fuck that.
Also, it sucks that we didn't get Narancho fighting, Talking Heads. Like, just, yeah. Like, an entire, like, mission where, like, the, I don't know, like, your inputs are swapped to, like, dodge and punch are mixed up or something.
Mm-hmm.
And you get into a fight in the bathroom.
That sounds, like, awful. I'm glad they didn't do that.
No, I want you to suffer is the thing.
I wanted a part with Abaccio where it's like the Metal Gear Solid thing where you're getting tortured, except it's you just trying not to die so that Moody Blues can finish the imprint.
Oh, I thought you were going to say where you had to put your controller into the second player slot.
Oh, that'd be cool too. I don't know what that would accomplish, but yes.
That's how you control Moody Blues.
Oh, okay.
This game would be so much better if you had to, like, control the stand and the characters independently with two different controllers.
No, that would suck.
Damn it.
Stop lying.
Jay, you're a sick freak, but don't worry. Next episode, we're dealing with even sicker freaks.